Good morning. This is Suresh from KIT. I am very happy to see you through this video. Today, we are going to talk about the parameters of transmission line. When I say parameters, there are two different types of parameters. Basically, one, series parameter. Number two, shunt parameter. Series parameter are like resistance and inductance. Series parameter of resistance and inductance. Shunt parameter of admittance, or I can say as a capacitor. Shunt parameter of admittance or capacitance. These parameters like resistance, inductance, admittance or capacitance, shunt capacitance is going to affect the performance of the transmission line. Now we are going to discuss in detail how this affects the performances. Basically, transmission line is classified into three different types. One, short transmission line. Two, medium transmission line. Three, long transmission line. Short transmission line is basically the distance covered. If a distance covered from point A to point B is 80 km or 50 miles, then that is said to be short transmission line. A transmission line which covers a distance of 240 km and less than 240 km or 150 miles or less than 150 miles are said to be medium transmission line. A transmission line which covers a distance over 240 km, that is 240 km plus, are said to be long transmission line. Based on the distance coverage, the performance or parameter, the performance of the transmission line will differ based on the parameters as I told earlier. Resistance, inductance and admittance is going to affect based on the distance. And coming to the first parameter, as I told, resistance. Resistance is given by rho L over A. The rho is the resistivity, L is the length of the conductor, A is the area of cross section of the conductor. So depending upon the material used, rho value will change. Depending upon the size of the conductor, the area, the resistance going to change inversely proportional. And depending upon the length of the conductor, the resistance will change. Therefore, this resistance is going to affect the performance. It is going to introduce a loss called I square R loss, which is called copper loss, or which is called varying loss, because this I is not constant. This I is not constant in a transmission line. Therefore, we can say that this loss is a varying loss. It depends upon the load as well as the resistance. So, if the resistance is changing, means it's only because of the length or because of the area or because of the resistivity of the conductor. When I say inductance, inductance L, it is given by the letter L, inductance, which is equal to xi by I, where xi is the flux linkage, and I is the current passed through this circuit, and current passed through the circuit or the transmission line. So L is xi by I, which is Henry. The unit for resistance is ohms. Therefore, these two parameters, resistance as well as the inductance, are called the series parameters. This series parameter is going to affect the performance in two different modes. One, it is going to affect the efficiency of the transmission line, or it is going to affect the regulation of the transmission line. We will discuss in detail how this is going to take care, how the performance is going to vary with inductance, that we will discuss. Because resistance is very simple, the effect of resistance is more appreciable only in medium transmission line or in long transmission line. In short transmission line, the resistance is not that much appreciable. Okay, now let us go to the next one. Before going to study about the deep study about the inductance, let me want to inform you, or let me want to make you to understand. From the field point, field theory, that is the electromagnetic field theory, you might have learned in electromagnetic field theory about magnetic intensity, magnetic field intensity. So you should know the you should know about the magnetic field intensity. Magnetic field intensity, intensity H, as well as you should know about the inductance. You should know about the inductance in two ways. One, due to internal conductor or internal flux linkage, and external flux linkage, which you might have been studied earlier in the electromagnetic theory. So from the prerequisite of electromagnetic theory, I would like to tell you that magnetic field intensity H due to the conductor between outside the conductor and the internal conductor is given by L internal, which is equal to flux internal by I, which is already known as mu naught by 8 pi, where mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 over 8 pi, which is equal to 1 by 2 times of 10 to the power 7 Henry per meter. Similarly, flux external is equal to a 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln T by R, Henry per meter. These are the two basic things which already you have learned from electromagnetic theory. To understand the inductance of a transmission line, these two parameters are very, very important. That is, flux due to the inductance due to the internal point and inductance due to the external part. So before going to the inductance, there are two different types of inductance in case of transmission line. One, symmetrical calculation, symmetrical calculation of inductance, and number two, unsymmetrical calculation of inductance. When I say symmetrical calculation of inductance, it means in a transmission line, if the distance covered by a three-phase transmission line or similar, let us say this is conductor number 1, this is conductor number 2, and this is conductor number 3, then the distance between the center of the conductor to the center of the next conductor and the center of this conductor to the next conductor, however, if the distance are said to be symmetric, distance are said to be symmetric, that is, let us say this is d1,3, d 1,2, this is d 2,3. It means that d of 1,2 is equal to d of 2,3 is equal to d of 1,3, which is equal to d. It means that the distance is similar. Then that is said to be symmetrical calculation. When you go for another calculation, that is another method of calculation or another type, I can say this is called unsymmetrical calculation. This is called unsymmetrical calculation, where the distance between each conductors are not similar. It means that here, as I say, this is 1, conductor number 2, this is conductor number 3, or we can say A, B, C. Here also we can say A, B, C. Now the distance between A to B or B to C or C to A is not equal. It means that D12 is not equal to D23, it is not equal to D13. So we cannot say D is not equal. So we can say, sorry, we cannot say D is equal. In this case, we need to go for a special type of system called transpositioning. I'll talk to you about what is transpositioning in detail when we discuss about that. Unsymmetrical calculations. Now we will go for the symmetrical type of calculation of inductance. Now we will go to the symmetrical type of calculation of inductance. So if you want to go to a deep discuss, first you should model or you should assume that the three phase conductor are said to be symmetrical as shown in the figure A, B, C. The distance is D, B, D. So here it is, as I told, it is symmetrical. It means equal spacing provided. this equal spacing provided between conductor to conductor, conductor to conductor. That is the meaning for equilateral spacing or symmetrical spacing. Here A, B, C, B, the three conductors, we know that A, B, C, B, three conductors, and let D, 1, 2, as I said, D be the distance between the conductors, D be the distance between the conductor, and assume that the conductor size, that is A, B, C conductor size, all the radius, I can say the radius are similar. So R of, that means that R is similar, radius is similar, and therefore the current flowing through the conductor IA, IB and IC are the current flowing through the conductor, or the current flowing through the conductor, not the flowing through the conductor. So before going to derive an equation for inductance, first you have to assume that the current IA plus IB plus IC is equal to 0, meaning IA plus IB plus IC is equal to 0 means the system is said to be symmetrically spaced or balanced condition. Current are balanced, and therefore I can write IA plus IB is equal to minus of IC, or I can write IB plus IC equal to minus IA, as you like. You can write, this is a simple mathematics. So I am assuming that system is balanced. From the balanced condition I am writing IB plus IC equal to minus IA. Next we have to find the total inductance of the circuit. It means if you want to find the inductance L, IA, first you should know about the current, next you should know about the flux linkage. So flux linkage, we are calling it as lambda here. Flux linkage we call it as lambda A. So you know about the current already. Now we want to calculate about the flux linkages. So the total flux linkage of phase A, I am first considering only phase A, first phase, which is given by phi, lambda A is equal to L A A of I A plus L A B of I B plus L A C of I C. It means that inductance of self inductance of the conductor A, what we are considering into the current, as well as the mutual inductance A to B, this is mutual inductance. These two is very, very important. That is, first we are considering the conductor, first conductor, as I told, we are considering the conductor A. If we consider a conductor A, first we want to consider the self. LAA is a self, as well as LAB is the mutual, and LAC is a mutual. From this conductor to this conductor, it's a mutual inductance. From this conductor to this conductor, again a mutual inductance. And for this self, therefore the total flux linkage is given by the self of this one plus the mutual between this one and the mutual between this one, that is A to B and A to C. That is the equation here we are writing as lambda A is equal to self inductance plus mutual inductance plus mutual inductance. That is, after we know the equation already, the just substituting the self values and mutual values, we'll get lambda A is equal to 2 into the power of 1 is 7 IA ln of 1 by R, because self D is absent. The D is a distance, in self D is absent. So I am taking D is 1 plus IB into ln of 1 by d. Here d is d of AB. Here d is 1 by d of AB. Since r is 1, similar d of AB plus IC ln of 1 by d, which is d of AC into Henry per meter. After simplification, we get 2 into 10 to the power of 7 into IA ln of 1 by R1 minus IA into ln of 1 by D. 1 by D, because here IB, IC is there, IB plus IC, because already we know that IB plus IC is equal to minus IA. That is what I have written here as IA. Therefore, IB, IE, just I am simplifying, I am writing as IA, minus of IA. This we already assumed that IB plus IC is equal to minus IA. So just I am introducing that one. I am simplifying that one. Okay. And therefore, now I can write this is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 IA. I am taking IA outside, therefore ln of 1 over R1 minus ln of 1 over D. This is in the form of log A minus log B. Ln A minus ln B. So I can write simply phi A is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 IA into ln of D by R prime. I am just here writing as R prime. So when I say, I have done a mistake here, is that this is R prime. This is R prime, where R prime is the self GMD, where R prime is the self GMR. Self GMR. Because when I considering here, for first conductor, it is a self, therefore it is a self GMR. Therefore, flux linkage phi A is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into IA into ln of D by R prime Henry per meter. If you want to find the inductance LA, then divide it by, that is lambda A by IA, which is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 ln D by R prime, where D is the distance, and R prime is the self GMR. So R prime is given by R into e to the power of minus 1 by 4. R prime is equal to R into e to the power of minus 1 by 4. Therefore, the inductance of a three-phase line for considering a single conductor LA, which is given by 2 into 10 to the power of 7 ln D by R. Therefore, inductance of a transmission line is majorly affected by two different parameters. One is the distance between the transmission line and the radius, that is the self radius, self GMR of the particular conductor. Similarly, we can calculate for LB and LC. LB and LC. I hope all you clear? Yes. Thank you for your patient listening. That's what I want to say here. Inductance is based on D and R prime. Thank you.